seeds, the foundation of the crops we produce and the food we consume. And sowing diverse varieties of seeds is a key part of agrobiodiversity. You might be wondering, what is agrobiodiversity? It's a subset of biodiversity, which is the variety of life on Earth. Agrobiodiversity is the variety of life that's necessary for everything that goes into the production of our food. Garrett Graddy-Lovelace, a professor at the School of International Service, is working on a project funded by the National Science Foundation. The goal of it is to learn more about three regions of the world where there is high agrobiodiversity.
Southern Central Appalachia is one. Yucatan, parts of southern Mexico, is the second. And then Cusco region of southern Andean Peru is the third. And all of those are regions with high agrobiodiversity, but struggling with community, food security, food sovereignty, food justice, nutrition. So the question was, what are the pathways by which agrobiodiversity could fulfill its potential in nourishing the communities here?
Along with synthesizing data on crop diversity, Garrett's team is meeting with farmers and activists in these regions who are involved firsthand in the food-related issues of their communities. A meeting already took place at this year's Heritage Harvest Festival, an event held at Monticello in Charlottesville, Virginia. The festival promotes gardening and local food and celebrates the contributions to American cuisine by enslaved workers. One of the project participants, Ira Wallace, is a farmer and a co-founder of the festival. When asked about the project, she had this to say.
Your place in the puzzle informs your analysis. And if we can synthesize something that takes all of those things into account, maybe we can get something that will work.
Participants collaborated on best agricultural practices and discussed how agrobiodiversity could nourish each of their communities.
We need people to be breeding, you know, new apple varieties and new strawberry varieties as we're breeding new potato varieties and new wheats and corns. And we need, you know, we need farmers to be growing food, not just growing commodities.
Commodity crops are any crops that are traded. Think corn or cotton grown in the U.S. And many issues arise from overproducing them, from the use of fossil fuels and chemicals to habitat loss and water pollution. Professor Garrett Graddy-Lovelace is also concerned about worldwide pressure to keep the prices of commodity crops low, a race to the bottom.
So there's this entire kind of apparatus of crises around the overproduction of commodity crops environmentally, also economically. If you overproduce a crop, the price, the farm gate price drops, it's raised to the bottom. And so it's been very destructive in agrarian livelihoods around the world.
On top of the problems that arise from overproducing commodity crops, farmers like Alea Frazier also recognize the issues that come with climate change. She emphasizes the importance of seed saving. That is, growing seeds season after season on a piece of land so they can adapt to it. And seed keeping, remembering and sharing from where seeds originate. In other words, sharing their stories.
As the climate is changing and shifting, you see a lot of chaos and upset people and upset ecosystems, but seeds, they're still going to adapt, they're still going to be resilient. So if we can learn from them and keep saving and keeping them and sharing their stories, I think we'd have a better chance at survival and resilience in the future.
Transforming the food system and growing more diverse crops is a must in the face of climate change, as problems like food waste, hunger, and the loss of varieties of crops will only be exacerbated in the future.
We have to take advantage of the agrobiodiversity that currently exists. We need to be breeding new, better plants that are adapted to this changeable, highly changeable climate that we now have, and that's only going to get worse.
Climate change is a major reason for why this project on agrobiodiversity is important. Synthesizing data on it and learning from people who cultivate biodiverse food systems that nourish their communities are some of the keystones to weathering the impacts of a warming world.
When we think about climate, people oftentimes think about cutting fossil fuels. But the agrobiodiversity, I think soon more and more people will realize, is really the crux of climate resilience.